Skeptic and then Donald Trump began his presidency a polarizing figure, he ends his first year a beleaguered one. As the anniversary of Trump's inauguration approaches on Saturday, the president's support has eroded, his opposition has gained energy and his party faces bleak prospects for the midterm elections in November, according to a new USC-Dornsife, Los Angeles Times nationwide poll. Just under one-third of those polled, 32%, approved of Trump's job performance, compared with 55% who disapproved and 12% who were neutral. That 23-point deficit represents a significant decline since April and the last USC-LA Times national poll, which found Trump with a 7-point approval deficit, 40% to 47%. Looking just at residents of 11 key swing states, Trump's standing is virtually the same, 33% approve, 54% disapprove, evidence that his problem goes far beyond the big, Democratic coastal states. Moreover, opposition to him has intensified, 42% in the poll said they disapproved strongly of Trump's job performance, up from 35% in April. A much smaller group, 15%, voiced strong approval, down slightly from April. The 55% disapproval closely matches the average of other recent, nonpartisan polls. The 32% approval is several points lower than the average, most likely because the USC-LA Times poll explicitly gives people the option of saying they neither approve nor disapprove, which not all polls do. Widespread disapproval of Trump's performance has also dragged down his party's standing. Asked which party's candidates they would favor if the congressional elections were being held today, those polled sided with the Democrats by 11 points, 51% for Democrats to 40% for the Republicans. Democrats have held their own supporters better than Republicans have. 8 in 10 people who voted for Hillary Clinton in 2016 said they definitely would vote for a Democrat for Congress if the election were held now. Just two-thirds of people who voted for Trump had a similarly definite intention of voting for a Republican. History indicates that with a double-digit lead on the congressional ballot question, the Democrats would be very likely to take the House in November, said Robert Trum, the veteran Democratic strategist who directs USC's UNRU Institute of Politics, which co-sponsored the poll. The Republicans could be in real trouble. That result comes despite the poll's finding of widespread optimism about the economic future, which normally would boost the party in power. The poll was mostly completed before the Oval Office meeting last week in which Trump used a vulgar word to describe African countries and said he would prefer to see more immigrants from places such as Norway. As a result, the poll doesn't reflect any change in Trump's standing that may have come from those remarks, which many Democrats, and some Republicans, have labeled racist. The poll was conducted online from DEC. 15 to January 15 among 3,862 respondents drawn from a panel designed to accurately reflect the country's demographics. Results for the full sample have a margin of sampling error of 2 percentage points in either direction. Panel members are part of a continuing research project into public opinion by USC's Center for Economic and Social Research, the poll's other co-sponsor. In 2016, the poll repeatedly forecast a Trump victory in the election. Throughout Trump's first year, he has focused heavily, indeed, almost exclusively, on tending to his core supporters, what the president often refers to as his BAS. Trump has used divisive issues such as immigration and controversies such as his criticism of NFL players who took a knee during the national anthem to rev up the enthusiasm of his backers. In 2016, his focus on the base succeeded, just barely, in getting Trump the votes he needed in key states to beat Clinton. Since then, Trump's support has remained mostly solid among groups that have backed him heavily since he won the GOP nomination. Residents of rural areas rate his job performance positively 51% to 38%, whites who identify as evangelical Christians approve 63% to 28%, and self-identified Republicans approve 74% to 16%. Among white voters, those without a college education approve of Trump's work by a narrower margin, 49% to 37%. Those with a college degree disapprove by more than 2-to-1, 65% to 28%. But the exclusive focus on his base leaves very little margin for defections, and over the last year, Trump has suffered some. Because the USC-LA Times poll questions the same people repeatedly over time, it can track those defections. About 1 in 8 people who said in April that they approved of Trump's job performance now say they disapprove. Most of those who had not made up their minds in April now have done so, and by almost 2-to-1, they have gone against Trump. The people who are waiting to see in the spring have mostly moved toward disapproval, said Jill Darling, survey director for the USC Economic and Social Research Center. Even among those who voted for him, Trump's popularity is tepid.